This tutorial will take a look at Color Contrast Analyzer version 1.1, which is a very useful program developed by the Pacillo Group. And it will check the color contrast of any document or site open on your screen to see if the text and elements against the background color meet Web Content Accessibility Guidelines version 2.1. If you simply type in Color Contrast Analyzer into Google's search box, you'll come to the Pacillo Group's developers website page on the program. And right here is a button to download it for Windows or Mac. And this takes you to GitHub. And you can scroll down. Here's version 1.1.1 at the top. If you're on a Mac, you would download this DMG file. And if you're on Windows, you would look for the exe. So I would click on CCA Setup 1.1.1.exe. Pick a place on your hard drive to save it to. When it's downloaded, I'm on Chrome. I'm going to pick Open and say yes to run the program. Okay, so I already have it installed, so I won't go through this process again, but you can see what the windows look like here. So once you've installed it, there should be a shortcut for it on the desktop, which is just this white A over the blue square. Just double click it to run it. And it opens up in its own window, which floats over your desktop. This newer version is built on Electron, which is a framework for creating applications using JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. The newer version's also built to check for WCAG 2.1 standards, which are the newer web content accessibility guidelines that look at the contrast of user interface elements and controls, as well as the text against the background. The older version checked against WCAG 2.0. I'm a fan of both the newer and the older version, but I have to say the older version had a feature that I can't find in the newer version, and that was to simulate color blindness for any region of the screen or loading an image file. So this is the older version, version 2.5. I'm going to shrink the newer version. And you can see I can drag this window over any part of the screen and pick the color blindness here at the upper right and see what someone with protanopia, deuteranopia, or tritanopia, or a monochrome would see. They also have a cataract simulator. So I haven't found this feature yet in the newer version, but I wanted to point it out in case you want to try the older version. And the link to get to the older version is down here at the bottom. For the previous non-Electron version, see the CCA Win or CCA OSX repositories. So you just go down here and click on that link. And you get taken to a different GitHub repository. And it looks like you can download the package for Windows 10 here for 64-bit or 32-bit. One of the nice things about both the older and newer version is that they have an eyedropper tool here, which will allow you to sample different colors of an interface. It's over here on the older version. So let me escape out of this and then shrink the older version. Let's take a look at some color combinations on CSU's homepage. So if I sample this dark green, which is our university green, against the white background, it tells me that it passes for large and regular text size at level AA. and it passes for large text only at the AAA level. If it was a graphical user interface element, like an icon or something, it would pass for that. Okay, so you can see that the text is cut off at the bottom. I can't see it, but I know that element is for the graphical user interface elements. If I test the gray on the side here, the CSU gray, see if I can target it. Let me try to get a better sampling of it. It's telling me that it fails for both large and regular text at the AA and AAA level. And AAA is better. So there's sliders up here. And you can do red, green, blue, or you can do hue, saturation, and luminance. I'm going to switch over to hue, saturation, and luminance. And if I drag the lightness down, I can see where it comes in and passes for large text. There it is for regular text. It's giving me a hex value here. And if you're worried that you're going to overshoot, you can highlight the numbers and type in. And get a different hexadecimal value at the top. So you can see where it transitions more easily that way. But you just keep dragging the lightness down until you get the best value that you can, where it passes the AAA level, and grab that hex code and then apply it. I know from inspecting this font for the gray text that it's 18 pixels and that translates to 13.5 points and it's slightly below what is larger text size for WCAG 1.2. So I'm going to go down to the bottom and test this CSU campus green against the university green and see if the contrast ratios fail. And yeah, I can see they fail all the levels, even for graphical objects. So this combination isn't good, and we shouldn't be using it if we care about meeting the WCAG standards. There is a color blindness simulation tool at the top if you go under the View menu. And that'll show you what the text looks like against the background for people with different color blindnesses and anomalies. It tells you the contrast ratios too. So if I play with this lighter green color here, I can see it passes here when I make it lighter. And I can just keep making it lighter until I reach something that's much better than what we had before to meet the AAA standard. So if you're curious about these standards, you can click on the arrow and drop it down, you can read what ratio they're looking for this level AA for regular size text, and the ratio 3.1 for the larger scale text, and they tell you what is considered larger scale, the 18 points or 24 pixels. And I can take a look at the AAA level. I'm going to go under Preferences at the top and I can't adjust the interface to get the font size smaller. So you can see there's still some bugs that they're working out with a newer version, because part of this interface is hidden. There's another feature under the edit menu called copy results, and if you do that, you can copy the results to a design document. I did Control V to paste it in, and it tells you what those hexadecimal values were for the foreground and background, and what ratio it was, 4.5 to 1, and what levels it met at. So to keep up with changes to the code, you can periodically check their web page for the latest download and see if there's been some bugs fixed and download the newer version. So they do have a way to report bugs, and if you have a GitHub account, you can report a new issue. And so that's the new Color Contrast Analyzer.